No. Boys are just placeholders. They come and they go.
You're my best friend.
I want to help you. But I won't let you kill him. That's a lose-lose. So we pick one that doesn't fit the
Take it.
maybe things will never be the same, but I'm not sure that I really loved the way they were before. And I don't know if I'm capable of loving anything anymore. My stomach's gaping open, I'm anxious to my knees. I toss and turn at night and hope that it's not a disease that is hereditary. Lord knows it's scary to think I might have made you into somebody like me. I wish that I could smile more, and maybe you would too. I don't believe in anything unless I look at you. I know I should be better. I know that I should sleep. I know that it's imperative I get enough to eat. So why do I feel helpless when there's tons of help around? And why do I feel lost when I'm never left unfound? And maybe it's the internet or strangers at the store. I just feel like I don't belong here anymore. I'm sweeter than my mother, but stubborn as my dad. And I thought I'd be the person that the little me never had. The walls are caving in now, but somehow getting wider, and there's chaos and a never-ending silence, and there's cries that come from hunger and defiance. I'm a giant, and I'm lonely, but it's not you who's supposed to hold me.
my defense, I only have 3 minutes, you know. But it's still my favorite part of every set, I'm not gonna lie. It's really fun. You know, it's a really strange thing, kind of the way that my career has gone, because I have a lot of brand new fans who are just starting to get into my music. But I feel like I've been doing this for so long. I've been touring for almost a decade now. Which is crazy because I'm only 27 years old. I'm almost 28, I guess. It was like a couple months away. Which is like, it's a big deal in the musician world to turn 28, you know? You guys better put me in a bubble for the next 3 months. It's especially strange, not just because I've been doing it for so long, but because last year I had a baby. Yeah, I gave birth. Isn't that nuts? I remember getting in the car on the way home from the hospital, just like holding his face like this the whole drive home in the car seat. Because I was so scared, for some reason, that he was gonna like go like this and just like not breathe or something. And that was the first of many brand new fears that I acquired as a parent when I used to be fearless, you know? Or I used to at least be very good at pretending I was, you know? But becoming a parent made me realize how actually fucking terrified I am of literally everything. But in a weird way, making music for and with you guys prepared me a lot for parenthood, because No, it really did. It really did. You know, because for years I just kind of like surrendered myself over to this thing, and I like lived, slept, ate, breathed everything for it, for the art, and I would spend all this time making records and being like, this is what it means to me, and this is what I want it to mean to them. And then I would put it out, and it would go out to the world, and all of a sudden people were like, well, this is what it means to me, or this is what I think it means. It would take on this life of its own. And that was really scary. So I was like, no! This is what I wanted it to mean. And I had to let the art go out and grow legs and become its own thing. And one day I'm gonna have to do that for my son Ender too. It's fucking scary, man. It's scary. I'm so lucky that some of you are old as shit. Old as dirt. But I'm just kidding. And some of you guys are very young. And you've given me this incredible insight into the type of world that my son's going to grow up in. And even though it feels chaotic and apocalyptic and like fucking hell sometimes, you guys give me a lot of faith. A lot of faith. And he's gonna grow up in a place that's pretty okay, you know? So thank you for that. It's gonna be okay. I wrote this song a couple years ago, and I wrote it about a person who made me feel like I was absolutely worthless without their validation. Yeah, they were wrong. It's cool. It's fine. You know what I mean? They were wrong. It's fine. But when I wrote the song, I felt like the world was fucking ending. And now when I sing it, all I can think about is how much better of a place I'm in since when I wrote it. We have a lot of show left tonight, guys. A lot of show left. And some of the songs that I sing are going to be about those places in my life, those times in my life when things were not so good. And I just want to say, things were not so good. It's funny. If you relate to my songs, the ones about the darker places and the darker times, and you come here tonight, and you are in a better place than you were when you related to them, I want you to make me a promise that no matter how hard you sing, no matter how hard you scream, no matter how visceral your body feels, when you leave the venue tonight, you're gonna fucking leave that person here too. Because they don't deserve to go home with you. You gotta leave them here, okay? Just like I do every single night when I walk off that stage. I leave them here, and you guys gotta do the same. Anyway, it's a whole lot of talking, but the song kind of deserves it, I guess. This song is called 100 Letters.
I said it's too late. I said please don't go.